3 months into 2016, and businesses have continued to disregard Zimbabwe's indigenization laws, as if daring our president and government to do something about this contemptuous behavior. Well, the law is the law. The law must be adhered to. We must never breed lawlessness as a nation. The failure to adhere to the laws of our land must attract immediate consequences, and these consequences must be severe and dire enough to ensure that the law is respected and adhered to. It is reassuring, therefore, to law-abiding Zimbabweans whose aspiration is that they must own their own economy through indigenization and economic empowerment, that Cabinet has boldly spoken against such lawlessness that has continued to deprive the indigenous majority ownership of their economy. Laws must be enforced to realize the people's aspirations. As Cabinet ministers, we swore an oath to uphold the law and were duty-bound to ensure that the law is adhered to and enforced. Cabinet has therefore directed that on 1st April 2016, all line ministers invoke Section 5 of the Indigenization and Economic Empowerment Act, Chapter 1433, against all non-compliant businesses in the sectors that they superintend. Invoking of Section 5 of the Act is purely a technical process which comes into effect by pure operation of the law. This process involves the following steps. First, the line minister should issue an order to a licensing authority to cancel licenses of non-compliant businesses. However, before that order is issued, the line minister notifies the non-compliant business in writing of the line minister's intention to cancel the operating license. Non-compliant businesses may show just cause as to why their license should not be cancelled. Line ministers, if there is no such just cause, line ministers will then direct the non-compliant businesses to become compliant. Failure to comply will result in the line minister proceeding to notify third parties that are likely to be affected by the cancellation of the license of his intention to cancel, of his or her intention to cancel such a license. Licensing authorities will then be required, without notice, to cancel the licenses of businesses that remain non-compliant after having been given room to comply. As part of this process, Cabinet has also directed that all line ministers must make available to the National Indigenization and Economic Empowerment Board a full and comprehensive list of all companies that are licensed to operate within their sectors within a week from 22 March 2016 for the purpose of verifying their indigenization status. I believe that these measures directed by Cabinet shall remedy the long-standing disregard of the Indigenization and Economic Empowerment Act, Chapter 1433, by non-compliant businesses. It is only such contemptuous businesses that face the full wrath of the law.